And we had actually been working on the theatrical version of this show. And while we were working on it, Disney Channel came to see it and said, we want to make that into a movie. And for some crazy reason, I got to keep my part. And it's my very first movie ever.
Come on, guys.
Not a kid anymore, and so at this point in my life to be learning a brand new skill was really exciting.
I think that's the best part. You know, we always talk about women, especially in this room, and a lot of moms who want to change careers or try something new at a different point in their life. And so really, this is another example that that's possible.
No, totally. And you know, not only, I mean, it's, you know, the same, I'm still acting, but it's just it's very different muscles that you end up using, and now I'd love to do it more and more.
So you'll do it more.
For sure you'll do it more.
So not your first film.
No.
And you wrote one of the songs?
Yeah, the song that opens the movie.
That's amazing. Did you, have you always wanted to write? Are you always writing?
Yeah.
How did that come about?
I released a lot of music, and I've been a writer on all of it. And I was in the Dolphin Tail movies, which is another movie for families. And Dolphin Tail 2, I wrote the song for the end credits of that one. So I had already had a little bit of experience in this world, and so it was such an honor to be able to write the opening song for our movie.
That is so exciting. So for the kids in the room, because I think we have a lot of kids who want to be performers or are performers or are singers or we have a dancer, what would you tell them about how to get to where you are?
Oh gosh, just continue to do what you love every day. I mean, a piece of advice that I've never forgotten was that you can be out of professional work at the moment, but if you're always honing your craft and working on it, you are always working. Like, you're never out of work if you're always doing something you love and being creative and pushing yourself creatively. So that's really all that I did. And you know, I auditioned, but I also was in community theater, and that's a great place to start to find out if you really love doing this. Yeah.
Great. And Susan, you have a long career in the film industry, and especially as really a woman at the top of your field. So how did you choose your projects, and how did you get involved with your projects?
Well, I try to make movies that are mostly from the female perspective, because that's my perspective. And I think it's underrepresented in Hollywood in general. And I also really love making movies for young people, because it's a really important part of your life. It's where you are formed. And I think that there aren't enough movies, live action movies especially, that speak to young people. And Disney Channel is one of the companies that makes these movies and does it so well. So when I heard about Freaky Friday, it was originally because I had worked with the director before on another movie, and they were calling to talk to me about him. And I said, well, since you don't have an executive producer, I'm throwing my hat into the ring. And next thing I knew, a couple weeks later, they were calling me to invite me on board. And I was thrilled, because I've always loved Freaky Friday, from the book to the first movie with Jodie Foster to the next movie with Lindsay Lohan and Jamie Lee Curtis. And then, of course, this iteration with music and dance was a joy every moment of every day, especially with these two amazingly talented women. So